So quite often when we use select, we are able to select only one particular field or whatever fields we have specified as part of the select clause. If you use with column, you can actually add additional fields on top of whatever are there as part of the data frame to get. But what if I want to get all the fields except for one field? That's where the drop will come into picture. You can drop a particular field from the data frame and you should be able to return the results. So in this case, if you have orders data frame, let's say I want to get only order customer ID, order ID and order status without order date. I can just say orders dot drop. And if you look at the syntax of drop, you can pass one or more columns in the form of strings or one column at a time. You cannot pass more than one column if you are passing it as column type. I don't know why this is available for drop. I'm not 100% sure. These are more than enough with respect to drop, because while dropping, we'll not be deriving anything. We'll just drop, right? So I don't know why this column overloaded function is available. There could be some reason which I'm not aware of. That being said, if I just want to drop one field, which is nothing but order date, I can one field, which is nothing but print schema. It has only three fields. However, as I mentioned to you earlier, this actually created a new data frame. So orders itself is not touched at all. So if you actually say orders.printSchema, it still have four fields. But when I say orders.drop, it will actually create a new field, but we are not assigning to anything. And hence it will be discarded after performing whatever we say here. Let's say I say show here, it will only return three fields. We can also drop multiple fields like this and get only the fields which we are interested in. However, if you want to pass as column name, you cannot just pass multiple fields as columns like this. It will fail, saying that there is no such function which can take two columns at any point in time. But if we remove one field with a dollar as qualifier, then you will be able to see three fields from the data set. Only one field is dropped. Okay, so this is how you can drop. Typically, we assign it to a different variable. Let's say val o equal to. Now, using this o, you can process further and you can save finally into files. So this is about dropping the fields from the data frame.